Hello everyone, this is Ankur Chaudhary, and in this video I'll be covering current affairs from 16th May 2018 till 31st May 2018. So these are the broad areas in which we'll be doing current affairs from. Let's start with awards and honors. Firstly, the Singchang Bhagan Community Reserve, an NGO from the West Kameng district of Arunachal Pradesh, won the India Biodiversity Award in the Conservation of Wildlife Species category for its effort in conserving rare wildlife resources in the area. Now, the Indian Biodiversity Award are given annually by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Climate change annually in the country. Next, some news from business. Firstly, Patanjali announced its entrance in the telecom sector with the launch of Swadeshi Samriddhi SIM cards in partnership or alliance with the state-run BSNL Corporation. Next, the Tata Trusts joined hands with the government to help it in development initiatives in 8 worst Naxal-affected districts in Chhattisgarh, which are covered under the Transformation of Aspirational Districts program of the government. Next, some important news from politics. Firstly, the 5th India CLMV Business Conclave was held at the capital of Cambodia, that is Phnom Penh. CLMV stands for the group of countries known as Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar and Vietnam. Now this country Laos, it was earlier known as Laos, but now it is known as Lao PDR, that is Lao People's Democratic Republic. Next, the HRD Ministry, that is the Human Resources Development Ministry of the Government of India, announced the launch of Samagra Shiksha Program, which subsumes 3 existing schemes, that is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan and Teachers Education. The objective of Samagra Shiksha Program is to improve the quality of education in the country. Now the program aims to view the education of a child from nursery till 12th holistically or a single continuous process, rather than viewing primary education separately and secondary education separately. Next, the Galvanizing Organic Bio Agro Resources Dhan, which is an abbreviation for Gobardhan scheme, was launched at NDRI. NDRI is National Dairy Research Institute. It is located in Karnal in Haryana. The Gobardhan scheme, it is a segment of the Swachh Bharat initiative. This scheme will focus on useful conversion of waste into energy. So what it will be doing is, it will be taking organic wastes from animals, especially in the villages, and converting that into energy in terms of biogas. Thus, it will perform multifarious functions. First, it will be keep the villages clean in the country. Secondly, it will provide additional sources of income to the rural population. Next, the state-run Energy Efficiency Services Limited, EESL, distributed over 30 crores LED. LED is light emitting diode bulbs across the country under the Unnat Jyoti by Affordable LEDs for All, which is also known as the Ujala scheme. Now, it is important here that Ujala scheme holds the world record for being the scheme under which the maximum distribution of LEDs have taken place anywhere in the world. Next, according to the PFRDA, that is the Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority, the subscriber base of Atal Pension Yojana has crossed 1 crore subscribers mark since its launch in May 2015. Till date, the scheme has collected rupees 3950 crores of contribution from subscribers. So the Atal Pension Yojana was launched especially for workers in unorganized sector of the country, right? Under this, 50% of the annual premium would be paid by the central government. The rest of the premium the subscriber had to pay. Next, important news from economy and finance. The 15th Finance Commission constituted a high-level group headed by Director of AIIMS, Dr. Randeep Guleria, to examine the strengths and weaknesses for enabling balanced expansion of health sector in the country. Next, the Multi-Commodity Exchange of India, that is MCX, launched India's first options contract on copper futures to bring greater vibrancy to the metals market. Now, options contract is a financial instrument in which two parties, they do an agreement. In the agreement, they decide that buyer of a commodity, in this case, let's say copper, the buyer would say, I would buy copper at pre-decided rate on this date, right? So that is an options contract. Next, according to the AFR Asia Bank Global Wealth Migration Review, India is the sixth wealthiest country in the world with a total wealth of $8,230 billion. So total wealth is nothing but the addition of personal wealth held by all the Indians in the country. The richest country is of course USA in this case. Next is China, followed by Japan. These are the top three. Next, India dragged the US to the World Trade Organization's dispute settlement mechanism over the imposition of import duties on steel and aluminium. So in May, USA decided to increase the import duties that it imposed on steel and aluminium imports. India exports about $1.5 billion of steel and aluminium to the USA. Now, of course, its interests have been negatively affected. So it has taken this particular grievance or problem to the World Trade Organization. Now, in the World Trade Organization, if a country drags another country in a trade dispute, firstly, a consultation process takes place. That is, negotiation takes place between these two countries. If the issue is not resolved in a mere consultation process, then the process is shifted to the arbitration process in the WTO. Next, BSE India, that is Bombay Stock Exchange, Asia's first stock exchange, received recognition as a designated offshore securities market, that is DOSM, from the United States Security and Exchange Commission. The SEC is the regulatory body in the USA, for example, what SEBI does in the country, thus becoming the first stock exchange in India to receive DOSM recognition. Now, the significance of this recognition is the US investors can purchase and sell stocks on the BSE without having to register themselves with the United States SEC, which used to happen earlier. Next, some important people in the news. Firstly, the book Straight Talk, authored by Abhishek Manu Singhvi, who is a member of the Rajya Sabha, was released by the Vice President. Next, former US astronaut Alan Bean, who was the fourth man to walk on the moon, passed away in Texas, United States at the age of 86 years. Next, Mr. Anil Kumar Jha was appointed as the Chairman and Managing Director of Coal India Limited. CIL is a state-owned coal mining company which is headquartered at Kolkata. Next, the government appointed former Supreme Court Judge C.K. Prasad as Chairman of the Press Council of India for a second term. So the Press Council of India is a statutory and quasi-judicial and is responsible for regulating the conduct of print media only. So it is statutory, it has been established under an act of the parliament, it is quasi-judicial, it also has the power to punish people in the print media if they do something wrong or print something controversial news, right? And it controls only the print media, so it does not control the electronic media, that is television, news, etc. Next, BJP leaders Ganeshi Lal from Haryana and Kumbanam Rajashekharan from Kerala were appointed as governors of Odisha and Mizoram respectively. Next, Indian botanist Dr. Kamaljeet S. Bawa was conferred with the prestigious Linnean Medal in Botany from the Linnean Society of London, thus becoming the first Indian to win the award ever since it was first constituted in 1888. Now, the Linnean Medal is given every year, but alternatively. So 1 year it would be given to someone from the field of botany, and the next year it would be given to someone from the field of zoology. Next, Mr. Nasir ul Mulk, a former Chief Justice of Pakistan, was appointed as the interim Prime Minister of Pakistan until general elections are held on July 25, 2018. Next, 28-year-old Nima Jangmu became the only woman in the world to climb three highest peaks in Nepal above 8,000 meters in one season within 25 days, that is Mount Everest, Mount Lhotse and Mount Kanchenjunga. Next, Pankaj Saran, a 1982 batch officer of the Indian Foreign Services, was appointed as the Deputy National Security Advisor. The National Security Advisor, NSA, is Mr. Ajit Doval. So, Pankaj Saran has joined as the Deputy NSA. Next, the former Supreme Court Judge, Justice R.K. Agarwal, was appointed the President of the National Consumer Disputes Redressal Commission. Now, the NCDRC is also a statutory body. It was established under the Consumer Protection Act of 1986. Consumer Protection Act of 1986. It is also a quasi-judicial body, that is, it can pronounce punishments on its own. Now, for all the consumer related disputes in which the product in question is above the value of rupees 1 crore, they can be referred to, or these cases are handled by the National Consumer Disputes Redressal Commission. For products of lower values, there are different state level consumer disputes redressal commissions as well. Next, Ms. Sangeeta Bahl, former model and entrepreneur from Jammu and Kashmir, became the oldest Indian woman to have scaled the world's tallest peak, that is Mount Everest, at the age of 53 years. Next, Ms. Sudha Balakrishnan, the Vice President of National Securities Depository Limited, was appointed the first ever Chief Financial Officer. This is very, very important for all the exams. Of the Reserve Bank of India, she will hold the rank of Executive Director and will have a 3-year term. So she'll be the first Chief Financial Officer of the RBI, Ms. Sudha Balakrishnan. Next, sports. Firstly, India's top ranked under 19 player Akarshi Kashyap lived up to her top billing as she won the girls single title of Yonex Sunrise All India Junior Ranking Badminton Tournament. Next, the Chennai Super Kings won the 2018 Indian Premier League IPL 11 after defeating Sunrisers Hyderabad in the final, thus clinching their third IPL title. Next, Indian cricket team's skipper Virat Kohli won the International Cricketer of the Year at the CSAT Cricket Ratings Award. Next, top discus thrower Mr. Vikas Gowda retired after competing at the highest level for more than 15 years, during which he became the first and only Indian male to win the Commonwealth Games medal in the discipline. So, the discipline was discus thrower. Next, Indian opener Shikhar Dhawan was presented the International Batsman of the Year award. Again, we are talking about the CSAT Cricket Awards. While New Zealander Trent Bolt won International Bowler of the Year award, Afghanistan leg spinner Rashid Khan was presented with the T20 Bowler of the Year award. Next, some important miscellaneous news. Firstly, the World No Tobacco Day was observed on May the 31st with the theme Tobacco and Heart Disease. Next, the International Day of UN Peacekeepers was observed on May the 29th. The theme was UN Peacekeepers 70 Years of Service and Sacrifice. Next, Colombia became the first Latin American nation to join NATO as a global partner. Now, NATO was formed in the year 1949. It is an intergovernmental military alliance under which the members commit that if any of the members are attacked by another nation, it would amount to an attack on all these nations. It currently has 29 full members. Next, the WHO, that is the World Health Organization, validated Nepal for having eliminated trachoma as a public health problem, which is a milestone as the country becomes the first in WHO Southeast Asia region to defeat the world's leading infectious cause of blindness. Now, trachoma is a bacterial infection caused by chlamydia trachomatis. Next, May 22nd was celebrated as the International Day for Biological Diversity to increase understanding and awareness of biodiversity issues. Next, China successfully launched a relay satellite to enable a rover to communicate with the Earth from the Moon's mysterious far side, or which is also known as the dark side of the Moon, as this is a side which is always facing away from the Earth. So China is planning to send a rover on that particular side as part of China's goal of being the first country to send such a probe. It is named QQiao, which stands for Magpie Bridge. It is a 400 kg satellite which has a designed life of 3 years. Russia unveiled the world's first floating nuclear power station, in its northern city of Murmansk. Next, May 18th was celebrated in over 100 countries as International Museum Day. The 2018 theme was Museums and Hypercommunication, New Approaches and New Public. Next, the Andhra Pradesh government declared official symbols for the state. Neem and blackbuck were declared as the state tree and animal respectively. Similarly, rose-ringed parakeet was declared as the state bird, while jasmine as the state's flower. Next, the Gaj Yatra was rolled out by Union Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change and the Wildlife Trust of India from Meghalaya. It is part of the 18-month long national campaign to protect India's national heritage animal, that is elephant and its habitat. Next, the United Nations Environment Programme recognized Cochin International Airport of Kerala as world's first fully solar energy powered airport. This of course is a very important news. Next, the first ever bilateral joint military training exercise Harimau Shakti 2018 were held between India and Malaysia in Malaysia. Next, according to report by WHO, human triggered factors like habitat loss due to deforestation and climate change set off infectious outbreaks such as the recent Nipah cases in Kerala. Next, Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh announced that Chhattisgarh would get a specialized anti-naxal combat force called the Black Panther on the lines of Greyhound unit. Now, Greyhound units were founded earlier to fight against the Naxalites in the states of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Next, in a bid to enhance combat capabilities in Naxal hit areas of Bastar region in Chhattisgarh, the CRPF, that is the Central Reserve Police Force, for the first time decided to include local representation in the special unit. This special unit was numbered as 241 and was named as the Bastaria Battalion. This is important. Next, Prime Minister Narendra Modi kick-started work for the Zojila Tunnel, which will be India's longest and strategic bi-directional tunnel to provide all-weather connectivity between Jammu and Kashmir, Srinagar, Kargil and Leh. Next, Pakistan voiced concern over the inauguration of the 330 megawatt Kishan Ganga hydroelectric project in J&K, saying that inauguration without resolution of dispute between the two countries will tantamount to violation of the Indus Water Treaty. Now, the Indus Water Treaty was signed in the year 1960 between India and Pakistan. Under this agreement, the water sharing of Indus rivers was finalized between India and Pakistan. Right? So, this particular project, Pakistan is concerned that India would divert its water and thus violate the provisions or the agreements made under the Indus Water Treaty 1960. Next, India has pledged to eradicate tuberculosis by 2025, which is 5 years ahead of the global target set by the World Health Organization. So with that, we come to the end of this presentation. Thank you so much.